Hey there, everyone. I feel like I'm constantly saying this, but we're having a heat wave, but I feel obliged to say it again because you've got like panting dog in the background. So I'm sorry if that gets a bit noisy. Poor darling, he's had a haircut and I've put a shell pool outside. I've done whatever I can do, but it's 42 degrees Celsius and it's, what's the time? 10 o'clock at night. So it's not going to cool down overnight, obviously. This week, Jim chose the topic, and it's from one of our viewers. And his name is John, and he lives in London, which I thought was really exciting. I love London, and it's nice to get a topic coming or arriving from that way. So thank you, John. And the topic is, have the members of the team all rid themselves of internalized homophobia? If so, what is their secret to achieve this, particularly for people over 40? Well, I'm 46 years old. I'm going to speak more to internalized fear. The reason for that is, internalized homophobia is quite strong to me, and I do think that, I mean, a lot of LGBT people often say to me that they have internalized or have had internalized homophobia. It's really, really common. I honestly don't think I have. I've definitely had internalized fear. Could I be wrong about this? Absolutely. Because we are often very blind to our own bias or to our own judgment. And especially we can be very blind to our own prejudice. But the reason that I think it may differ is I have had that prejudice towards other groups of people outside of the LGBT community, and I have internalized that. And I know what that looks like once I've realized it and come across it. So probably the most striking example of that, and I've done it. I mean, look, we've all been judgmental. I've been judgmental, I've judged everyone else myself. But the most striking example of doing that is that whole thing of being born female, and I internalized that judgment of woman and at times splattered it because I was railing against it because of the Because I, but because I took on the prejudice and internalized it. And once I realized that, and once I realized that the definition I was hearing didn't necessarily need to be me, and there was this big gender spectrum and all of those things that dissipated. However, with homophobia, I never recall a time of having prejudice or bias towards LGBT people in any way, even when I was a child. And that could largely be due to my family, because while we were surrounded by plenty of hate, as many people are, they never projected that onto LGBT people that we knew. They often didn't discuss it and avoided the subject and all of that thing, but I never heard anything negative come from them. Which says something in the wider context of our communities, because I guess a sample size of one, you can't really count that. But I think I didn't have that because I wasn't taught that. In terms of internalized fear, definitely. And that's fear of being judged for being LGBT, fear of being discriminated against, fear of not being liked because I'm LGBT. Absolutely have all of those things. It feels very different. And I could just be the terminology in my mind that's seeing the two things as very separate. I think internalized homophobia is extremely dangerous. It's dangerous to the person who lives with it, and it's dangerous to the people around them. And if you look at the people who lash out at the LGBT community, as opposed to people who may say things like I've often heard people here say things like, I don't know why everyone's going on about marriage equality all the time. It's driving me crazy. Don't we have better things to do? I don't know why they want to get married anyway. Getting married isn't that great. I'm married, I hate it. So on one hand, they're not being supportive. But on the other hand, they don't care enough to actually bother to go out there and rail against LGBT people, or certainly they would never hurt anyone, and it would take very little if an LGBTQ person turned up in their family or friend circle to change their mind. They're just not in a space where they're thinking about it. The people that lash out, the people that are the most violent towards themselves and others, are people with internalized homophobia over and over again. And often when you see very public figures who are extremely prejudiced, complete bigots about LGBT people, somewhere down the track, they come out as LGBT themselves. So I do think it's an important thing to address, to move on from it. I'm gonna put this in two places. How I've moved on from the internalized fear, I still have it. I should say I'm not running around free from it. But how I move on from it, the easiest way for me, which obviously is not the easiest way for other people, most of that fear comes from when people don't know. When people do not know that I'm gay, in my head I'm thinking, when they find out, will they judge me? Will it change this whatever relationship we have now? Will it turn into me being discriminated against or excluded? How do they feel about these things really, regardless of what they say to my face? The list of what goes on in my head goes on and on and on, and the only way to get rid of that list is to tell them. Because then regardless of what they think, it's irrelevant. I don't have to think about it anymore. So that's been the only method really that works in terms of that internalized fear. It's just, if I start getting that talk, that self-talk in my head, the fastest way to get rid of that and put my energy into something else is just to tell whoever it is triggering that. Internalized homophobia can be more difficult. But one of the reasons I admire people who sit around and watch channels like this and contemplate coming out, I admire the fact that they're out to themselves. I don't care if you haven't told a soul, because if you never tell a soul, you're not going to be a danger to yourself or your community because of that. I'm not saying that you don't hold that internalized homophobia or transphobia or whatever it is, because a lot of people, I know people that have been out for years and years and years that tell me that they do. But to acknowledge who you are to yourself at least doesn't tip it over into that dangerous category. That's all I've got to say, really. I'm going to quietly go away and melt somewhere. I'll see you all next week. Bye for now.